In a market economy, price is often impacted by supply and demand. Let's take a look at some definitions that we'll be using. Supply. It's the amount of goods or services that producers make available for sale at a given price. Demand. The amount of goods or services that buyers will purchase at a given price. The market. It's the exchange process between sellers and buyers. Now, when we use the terms sellers and buyers, it links back to this idea of suppliers and those who demand. So sellers are the producers of goods or services who make the supply available. Buyers are consumers or those making purchases who create a demand for the goods and services. Now suppose that we had three farmers all growing apples and they have different prices. So one farmer's selling apples for $1.25. Second farmer is selling apples for $1.75, and the third farmer is selling apples for $2.25. Now it's clear that they're getting all their apples from the same tree, so they're identical. So you were looking to purchase apples. Which of these farmers would you buy your apples from? And it's very likely that the grannies would make their purchases from the same farmer. They're looking for the best possible value to buy these apples. Now, let's suppose they have it in their heads that they're going to use those apples to make their apple pie. They've purchased the most affordable apples available and made their apple pies. If we were to plot the relationship between price and the quantity of apples demanded, we would end up with a curve that looks something like this. This curve is called the demand curve. It shows the relationship between price and the quantity demanded. So, if price is at $4, how many apples are our grannies likely to purchase? Well, what the graph shows us is that at a price of $4, somewhat less than 10 apples, so 8 or 9 apples is likely what grannies would be prepared to buy if the price is as high as $4. If price is a bit lower, suppose $3, how many apples will our grannies purchase? Grannies will purchase approximately 30 apples if the price is $3. Our demand curve shows that at a price of $2, demand will be approximately 55 apples. And if the price for our apples ever were to go as low as $1, demand would increase to just under 80 apples. Now, keep in mind what we just saw. If prices increase, what happens to demand? Demand goes down. The goods or services became more expensive. The grannies can't afford to buy as many apples, and they choose not to buy as many apples. Now, if prices drop, what happens to demand? Demand will go up. Grannies can afford to buy more apples to make more pie, and they may choose to buy more apples instead of other more expensive fruit. This is called the law of demand. Now let's look at the supply side. Farmers. Farmers are the producers and suppliers of our apples and other fruits and vegetables. If you were a farmer and you could grow apples and the selling price was $3, or you could grow bananas for a selling price of $2, assuming that the profit margins are comparable, which fruit would you grow? Exactly. As prices go up, other businesses will enter that industry in an attempt to take advantage of the higher prices and the higher profit margin. What else happens? Well, the existing farmer who's already growing apples may choose to increase their capacity by planting more apple trees. it's worth this added investment because prices are high and they're able to make that much more money. If we were to plot this relationship between price and the quantity being supplied on a graph, we would end up with a curve that looks somewhat like this. This is called the supply curve. It shows the relationship between price and the quantity that our farmers are willing and able to supply at a given price. If the price of apples is a dollar, how many apples will our farmers supply? Our curve shows us that if the price is a dollar, 20 apples will be supplied. If the price is $2, our farmers would be prepared to supply something like 45 apples. At a price of $3, our farmers will supply approximately 70 apples, and if the price were ever to get as high as $4, our farmers would likely supply somewhat more than 90 apples. Now remember what we just saw. What happens to supply if prices increase? Supply also increases. It's worth it for farmers to plant more trees to grow more apples. Farmers that are currently in a different industry, growing bananas or oranges or some other fruit that are less profitable, will stop what they're doing and they'll start growing apples, increasing the supply further. What happens to supply if prices drop? Well, then supply drops. So the relationship between price and the quantity supplied is called the law of supply. If we were to take the supply curve and the demand curve and plot them together on the same graph, what would we get? Well, there's a point where the two curves intersect. This is called equilibrium. It's when the amount being supplied equals the amount being demanded. Or in other words, a certain number of apples got grown and are available for sale, and every single one of them sold. There were no extra ones unsold, and every person that wanted to buy an apple was able to buy an apple. If we were to trace this point, this equilibrium point, back to price and quantity, what would we see? Well, we would see that the equilibrium price is approximately $2.25, and the quantity at that equilibrium point is about 50 apples. So you could think of it this way. If the grannies and farmers were to get together and negotiate a fair price, what would it be? A price where all of the grannies' apple needs get met, but the farmers are still able to make a profit. Well, it would be about $2.25, and 50 apples would be made available for sale, and they would all be sold. Interesting question. What happens to price if demand is greater than supply? By the way, when demand's greater than supply, this is called a shortage. So imagine a situation where our three grannies show up at the market. They've got it in their mind that they're going to make apple pies tonight. They find out there's only one apple left at the market. Well, if they're really insistent upon making apple pie tonight, what may happen is a bidding war where the highest price gets to purchase the apple. This is going to cause prices to go up. So when there's a shortage, prices will increase. Now, what happens to price if demand is less than supply? This is called a surplus. So in other words, supply is far greater than the amount that will ever be demanded by buyers. Well, prices are going to drop. Why? Keep in mind, the apples won't last forever. Eventually, they're going to start to get softer and bruised, and the farmer won't be able to sell them for anything. It's better to get some money than nothing. So in an attempt to sell these apples, the farmer will gradually start lowering the prices. It may be that the grannies have a different fruit in mind, but if the price for the apples becomes low enough, they may be encouraged to buy the apples instead of something else.